Good morning, everyone. It's Wednesday. We are on the floor of the New York Stock Exchange with Jim Cramer to talk about the markets. And Jim, let's begin with politics. Gary Cohn expecting tax reform by Thanksgiving.
Yeah,
what do you think?
I think that's unrealistic. I think that the president has sidetracked the agenda, and I think that Congress is still trying to do repeal and replace. So they always have been talking about that they'd be done by the end of the summer. There's been many different deadlines that are missed. I want to see a debt ceiling lifted before I can even believe anything about tax reform.
All right, we also had Trump this morning taking aim at Amazon on Twitter, also that fiery press conference yesterday. How do investors digest all these?
The fiery press conference is really about the 13th Amendment, Nazism, and things that I have no, and who's fellow travelers to these issues. And there's really no place in the American discourse about it, so I think the president should know that. But I do think that the Amazon tweet is interesting because Amazon is a destroyer of jobs at bricks and mortar. It's a creator of low-paying jobs in assembly lines throughout the country. So it's not zero sum, though. It wipes out more than it creates. However, it lowers the price of goods to 317 million people. So if you're the Department of Justice Antitrust Division, I have yet to find the case that you can make against Amazon, given the fact that the Justice Department Antitrust Division is historically looking for companies that raise price, collude and raise price. Now, they might be able to make a predatory pricing case saying that they are pricing below to wipe out. But again, what they're doing is giving you a great discount. So I don't know the case as it could be made.
Okay, also Apple taking aim at Amazon, investing $1 billion in original programming?
Well, it's really taking aim at Netflix, not Amazon. And I think that what Apple can do, since they brought in the people who did Breaking Bad, and they've got a lot of firepower, and Tim Cook is personally interested in series, is they can attempt to try to replicate what Reed Hastings done. The issue here is that, as Buster Cohen, C-O-E-N, wrote so eloquently in TheStreet, is that there are still blockbusters that will get people to go to the theaters, and there are, and you need to be as incredibly creative as Netflix to get the directors worldwide that you need, and that's actually a touch. You need to have the touch of the people who are involved in the article that Buster talks about. That's who, besides the Breaking Bad people, that's who Tim Cook needs to get.
Have you seen Planet of the Apes?
No, I've not seen Planet of the Apes. I don't go to the movies, and I watch TV only on Netflix, really, for the most part. And, of course, sports, Comcast.
Yes. All right, Jim, let's talk about retail. Target following through on its UPod strategy.
Yeah, you know, they underpromised and they've over-delivered, but at the same time, remember, what you really want is real growth. They don't necessarily have it, but I am excited that Cat and Jack's over $2 billion business. That's a private label business that's lucrative. That the Nintendo Switch, which of course is powered by NVIDIA chip, has made hard goods better again. That the cash flow is good, and that the food and drug business is no longer in free fall. So, you know, look, Target's not my favorite. TJX is by far my favorite. There, they didn't underpromise, they just over-delivered. And I reiterate that TJX is by far the best so far in the retailers. I do think that both Gap and Walmart will be good.
All right, Jim, we're going to do a little retail lightning round. Coach.
Yeah, Coach was a very big disappointment because buried within the context, within the actual conference call, was a dramatic lowering of the gross margins that no one was looking for, and that was quite a surprise. It was a very disappointing call.
Urban Outfitters.
Urban Outfitters, again, you have to listen to the call, and what that call was about was really a very granular call about the progression of business in Anthropologie and Urban Outfitters throughout the quarter. Each month was better than the last. They didn't necessarily call a trough, and the CEO had some terrific comments about the elephant in the room, which of course is Amazon. But you did see that the first month of the quarter was the worst, and when we see that sequential gain, we do want to buy.
All right, what about Dick's Sporting Goods?
Dick's Sporting Goods conference call was a disaster because it talked about the need to be as promotional as possible to maintain share, fishing terrible, hunting terrible, apparel not that bad, but it was a conference call that made you want to sell, particularly because they bought back a ton of stock at 41. These buybacks are not working for some of these retailers, and I caution some of these CEOs to recognize that their stocks aren't the buys that they think. They are.
All right, Jim, we also have Alibaba reporting earnings tomorrow. Anything you're watching?
I've been behind Alibaba. I don't even care about this quarter, but I've been on Alibaba since Delivering Alpha, which is a CNBC product where I interviewed the people who run Alibaba when the stock was in the 90s and came back and said, it's for real. There are no accounting issues. They've got a great model. I think that Alibaba is terrific. If you one of the things to know about Alibaba is the trades are radical in the day that it reports. Sometimes it spikes big and then comes in. Sometimes it goes down at the opening. So what you want to do is you want to buy half your position ahead and then see if it opens down and buy the rest.
All right, moving away from retail, Bristol-Myers shares getting hit on a
cancer. I mean, this really, this is, they've got two drugs, Opdivo and Yervoy, and they've been trying to combine them and work against different kinds of cancers. This is renal cell, very hard cancer to beat. Their trial does not meet the endpoints. At the same time, the drug stocks don't really come in for sale anymore because interest rates are so low.
All right, Jim, on Stop Trading on Stock on the Street, you talked about Agilent Technologies.
Yeah, Agilent's been one of my favorites. We profiled it on Mad Money. They've got a very good test and measurement. But they are in biopharma. They're in energy. They do instruments, and instruments are a great business, as we know from Thermo Fisher and as we know from Danaher. Danaher, Action Alert's name. If Danaher were to get out of dental, that stock goes to 90. We are betting they're going to take action to get out of dental, which is why we continue to believe in Danaher. Otherwise, you would be a seller of the stock.
All right, Jim, we want to end by letting everyone know that you have a big interview tonight on Mad Money Valiant CEO Joe Papa.
Yes. Joe is made certain promises when he was on Mad Money. I question whether he could deliver them, particularly on the balance sheet, and he has. I look forward to speaking him. Action Alerts does not own the stock, and that's because of the balance sheet. By the way, when you see balance sheet, take a look at that TJX balance sheet, which is the stock that we own in retail. It's really beautiful. But I like to give people their due when they come back and they make promises and they deliver on them. And Valiant is not necessarily a growth stock, but it is not in the decline that it was before.
All right, we can't wait for that interview. That's tonight, 6 p.m. Eastern on Mad Money. Jim Cramer, thank you so much. For more information on the stocks Jim mentioned, please head back to thestreet.com.